why fins are needed in heat exchangers. So, as we know, when two fluids are brought into contact in a heat exchanger, the rate of heat transfer depends on the overall heat transfer coefficient. But, this overall coefficient is not an average of the two sides. It is strongly controlled by the fluid that has the lower individual heat transfer coefficient. For example, if one fluid has a very high coefficient, like steam, and the other has a very low coefficient, like air or a viscous liquid, then the overall coefficient will not remain high. Instead, it will drop down and become almost equal to that of the porous fluid. But, what will happen because of that? So, the first practical consequence is that the ability of the heat exchanger to transfer heat per unit area becomes much lower. Then, to achieve the same heat duty, the exchanger would require a very large heat transfer surface. In other words, no matter how good one fluid is at transferring heat, the weak side limits the performance of the entire system. And therefore, to prevent the design from becoming expensive, fins or other extended surfaces are used in heat exchangers. Because these fins increase the outside surface area of the tubes,